But sometimes these two things are at opposite ends of the spectrum. Movies that make money may not necessarily win awards. We see this, for example, in the Cannes Film Festival every year. It's rare that you have a movie that can achieve both. Li Ang's Brokeback Mountain might be an example of a film that managed to both win awards as well as make a lot of money, but these are rare.
所以现在这些导演也很苦恼，就是说，哎呦，怎么赚钱，怎么获奖？我觉得快把这些导演逼疯了。
Oh, this struggle, you know, this struggle, how to make money, how to win awards, this is driving us as filmmakers crazy.
所以我觉得其实我后来想冷静想一下，其实导演还是要拍自己能够最善于表达，拍着自己最能够打动自己的作品，其实这才是一个最好的结果。
After a period of quiet reflection, I've come to realize that at the end of the day, a filmmaker has to make the kind of film that he is most comfortable and able to make, and that way he can move himself as well as his audience.
比如我拍那个《那人那人那狗》这部片子，当时呢就是只是喜欢，只是觉得有人投资，我就去拍了。拍了之后，当时中国那个时候正开始进入有点商业化，比如说武打片，什么那个撞车的这种片子特别时行。他们就这片子，大家就觉得能上市场吗？所以这就是个问题。其实这个片在国内又获了金鸡奖，又在国外获了奖，获了很多奖，大家很喜欢，人也很感动。但是在这问题上就是成了一个问题。后来一个日本片商呢，就是把这个片子买到日本去了。日本就做了一个特别好的安排，当时他跟我说，这个片子我们准备有一年进行准备。当时我有点惊讶，因为这么一个小的电影，他要用一年准备，我觉得有点过分了。后来一年以后，我就去这个给他做了这个发行的准备。他并没有，因为这不是个大的商业片，并没有做那种特别商业的那些手段，而是做了一些适应和观众看的留言和一些报刊的这样的一些评论。然后4月7号在日本的一家片上，我们还很担心呢，因为也希望片方不赚钱。后来就一直放，大概连续放了3个月，后来就连续放了6个月，后来就从一个影院到几家影院，从几家影院到全国。结果这个片商买了以后，可是发了财，一下在就是中国电影在目前来讲，在日本在进行商业发行最好的一部影片，而且就是从那儿就中国，我认为就是中国很多电影，日本的这个发行方开始重视，而且开始重视中国的电影，就是我觉得特别是就是说，我觉得不是我一个影片受益，而是说整个中国电影，我觉得会带着一些好的倾向，因此我会觉得其实。电影是多样的，应该是不同的好的电影，这样才能够就是怎么去把它做进，就是比如营销好了，包括刚才这个蒋总说的啊，就是说我们很多片子放了你没看到就过去了，比如说中国是不是有一个比较好的艺术院线，这样提供大家一个机会，就是有不同的影片有不同的对待，这样才能更好的把各种影片推广出去，发行好，让更多的观众看到。
When I made Postman and the Mountain, that was a period when commercialization of the film industry had really seriously begun in China. And I made it, you know, first and foremost as a film that I wanted to make. It went on to do very well. It went on to win the Golden Rooster in China. It won awards overseas. And then when interest was expressed in acquisition of that film for distribution in Japan,and the distributor in Japan told me that they needed 1 year to make preparations. I was really quite startled. But nevertheless, the preparations went ahead. And the release strategy that was used in Japan was one that started out initially as a very niche kind of strategy, relying on word of mouth and quotes from reviews. And it started off, you know, very, 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 very small scale. But the film went on to play for 3 months, 6 months,And then it went nationwide, and of course, you know, it did very, very well. So I think the Japanese distributor really made a lot of money out of my film. It is a situation where what is also very important is that a movie that is made has an outlet for continuous exposure. Just now, Mr. Jiang talked about the fact that visibility of films sometimes the less mainstream films get pulled off the screen much faster than the mainstream Hollywood blockbusters. One of the ideas that I have is perhaps to have a dedicated art house circuit or dedicated art house screens where at least the shelf space that is given to these films would give them a little bit more breathing space to grow. But certainly that's been my experience with Postman and the Mountain. It was really quite a wonderful experience.
还有一个我觉得就是比如现在我们就是开始适应就全世界的这种商业的方式，那么我觉得就是逐步的在开始，我们也需要适应，我们要需要面对就是这个商业就是主流电影怎么去做，那么就是说你学习好莱坞怎么运用到自己的民族电影上，比如还有一个我认为还是有一个时代问题，刚才就讲的要有一个过程，就是现在的人可能就是有很多问题，但是他们可能在前赴后继的往前冲啊。但是我觉得比如说像金刚这样的电影，像天使爱美丽的这样的电影，除了他们文化的原因，还有一个更重要原因，就是说他们的思维是在那个环境和经济发展到一定程度的一个同步的表达，而我们中国人可能最早就是从一个太现实主义的角度出发，那慢慢的去在这个过程中，我想我们后边一些电影工作者和年轻人一定可以达到更好的那样的商业片的那样的一个境界，到那个时候我们可能就是会更成熟，会有更好的中国的大片商业片呈现给观众。
As we come to terms with and adjust to the systematization that Hollywood for example representsit becomes increasingly important for us to also learn from them. I feel that we have been through a period where we were too much a realism-driven or a reality-driven filmmaking industry. And you know, you look at productions like King Kong and the like, there is so much synchronization, not only in the filmmaking, but also of all the marketing sensibilities, the entire system is all so well-oiled. Now, I believe,with the changes that we are already seeing with more co-productions and more exposure, as we learn and as we become more systematized, that the younger directors, my younger contemporaries, will have even more and more opportunities to make films and to make films that will succeed on all levels. And if we are able to evolve and grow China's film production industry this way, I feel that we will be able to attain an even more ideal state of affairs.than the one that we presently have.
我想我们中国的电影，我们亚洲电影，新加坡的电影的前途一定是美好的。谢谢。
I'm confident that the future of China films, Asia films, and Singapore films is a very bright one indeed. Thank you.
蒋总和霍建起导演及陈先生的谢意，不要主管的有小小礼物，
也感谢国家图书馆，还有我们在座的新加坡的朋友们，有这么一个机会，能够跟大家交流。把中国的电影的情况介绍给大家，也更希望我们通过这次交流成为好朋友。谢谢大家。
Thank you also to the National Library Board for this opportunity to come and share with all of you and to exchange ideas. It is my hope that through this process of exchange, we will not only work more closely together but also become good friends. Thank you.
谢谢大家，最后请大家留下我们的 feedback form， 啊，谢谢。